Well, the national holiday of Gandhi Jayanti is being celebrated across the country like never before. In fact, Prime Minister Narendra Modi kick-started his ambitious Clean India campaign from the India Gate a while back, and leading from the front in the first, Narendra Modi wielded a broom himself outside the Valmiki Basti in Delhi and later outside Mandir Marg police station, all part of his utopian plan to make India litter-free by 2019.
मेरे साथ बोलिए महात्मा गांधी ने जिस भारत का सपना देखा था उसमें सिर्फ राजनीतिक आजादी ही नहीं थी बल्कि एक स्वच्छ एवं विकसित देश की कल्पना की थी महात्मा गांधी ने गुलामी की जंजीरों को तोड़कर मां भारती को आजाद कराया अब हमारा कर्तव्य है कि गंदगी को दूर करके भारत माता की सेवा करें मैं शपथ लेता हूं कि मैं स्वयं स्वच्छता के प्रति सजग रहूंगा और उसके लिए समय दूंगा हर वर्ष 100 घंटे यानी हर सप्ताह 2 घंटे श्रमदान करके स्वच्छता के इस संकल्प को चरितार्थ करूंगा मैं न गंदगी करूंगा न किसी और को करने दूंगा सबसे पहले मैं स्वयं से मेरे परिवार से मेरे मोहल्ले से मेरे गांव से एवं मेरे कार्यस्थल से शुरुआत करूंगा मैं यह मानता हूं कि दुनिया के जो भी देश स्वच्छ दिखते हैं उसका कारण यह है कि वहां के नागरिक गंदगी नहीं करते और नहीं होने देते हैं इस विचार के साथ मैं गांव-गांव और गली-गली स्वच्छ भारत मिशन का प्रचार करूंगा मैं आज जो शपथ ले रहा हूं वह अन्य 100 व्यक्तियों से भी करवाऊंगा वे भी मेरी तरह स्वच्छता के लिए 100 घंटे दें इसके लिए प्रयास करूंगा मुझे मालूम है कि स्वच्छता की तरफ बढ़ाया गया मेरा एक कदम पूरे भारत देश को स्वच्छ बनाने में मदद करेगा भारत माता की जय जय हिंद फिर से मेरे साथ बोलिए महात्मा गांधी महात्मा गांधी महात्मा गांधी महात्मा गांधी बहुत बहुत शुभकामनाएं
All right, in fact, a Prime Minister's push for a cleaner India administering that oath early in the morning, very crucial. We are going to be talking about, is it symbolism or is it going to be a game changer, this effort to get India clean by the year 2019. We have panelists with us to get a perspective on this. Mr. Dilip Churian, image consultant, Reena Gupta, member of the Aam Aadmi Party, and Javed Ansari, executive editor. All with me in the studio, Kamaljeet Sandhu, my colleague. She's been tracking developments from the Valmiki Sadan. Kamal, coming to you, those pictures that we're seeing on our screens right now, they're pretty unique in a sense. Give us the mood around that place and what you witnessed.
Well, it's not every other day the Prime Minister of the country will take a broom and actually sweep the streets. But out here at Valmiki Sadan, you know, it was spotlessly clean till the Prime Minister came in. And after he's gone, we can still see some sort of litter. So it's a matter of habit. There were mixed reactions coming in from people. Some said he didn't really have a message. The students, especially from the lower caste, at least from the Valmiki society itself, could not interact with the Prime Minister. The others who came from the NDMC schools were very delighted. The Prime Minister had spoken to them. They had given them autograph. So obviously there was some sort of interaction and the entire area was very excited about it. But yes, there is a symbolic message. The Prime Minister, who's taken the broom, and obviously we've heard about VIPs who've come here earlier, former Prime Minister Narasimha Rao, Arvind Kejriwal, who've come here, but seen as more as a vote bank politics, is being seen as something which is historic in terms of symbolism. Mahatma Gandhi has spent 214 days out here. So there is a lot of history associated with the place itself. But the fact remains, there is a message out there by the Prime Minister. There is a cleanliness drive. There is an oath which has been taken, that 100 hours in a year. But how much of this will actually sustain in terms of the campaign? That really needs to be seen. But right now, it's got the push from the top, from the Prime Minister, right, from the top cabinet ministers. Some of them obviously holding that broom for the photo opportunity or the camera itself. But definitely, it has to be a sustained campaign, a push forward.
All right. In fact, I'm being told Atin Khan too is joining us from Rajpath. I'm going to go to him in just a bit, but quickly let me first get in a reaction from Dilip Churian. Dilip, you heard this massive effort, but then again, mixed messages being perceived by people on the ground.
You know, this kind of mixed messaging is inevitable when you have a prime minister sweeping streets and when you have hundreds of school children and others playing their role for the cameras. What happens after the cameras go is the acid test. And I think that the Prime Minister recognizes that, which is why he's got a kind of linkage thought out at least and enunciated to the public, which is Clean Bharat, toilets for schools, and then health for the poor. So he sees this as a whole mission statement, which is going to go beyond just cleanliness. He has problems in the cleanliness thing, but this is a Prime Minister whose messaging is always start with the micro before you announce the macro. There are arguments at the macro level about the technology, about what needs to be done at a more governmental level. But I think he himself prefers this option.
All right. In fact, Javed Ansari, what do you make of this entire campaign? Of course, a start has been made right now, but is it symbolism or is it going to be a game changer? Your thoughts?
Look, it's a very good first step, irrespective of the political differences with Prime Minister Modi. This is a step that needs to be lauded. This is a step that needs to be followed. This is a first big step. There's a huge task ahead of us. And I just hope this remains above politics and this remains national. And it's a continued process. If we forget about it and if it's business as usual 3 o'clock onwards, then it'll be a very sad commentary. There needs to be a change of mindset, and perhaps such an initiative coming from the very top will prompt people to think twice before they litter.
All right, so sustaining it is going to be a challenge, and that's quite important really, because a push has been made. Now, will it be sustained is another question. Reena Gupta, member of the Aam Aadmi Party, what do you make of this campaign? We do know that the Aam Aadmi Party is giving a push to a campaign of its own. Also, what was the need for that when this was taking place, and your perspective on the way things are progressing this morning forward?
So I would agree with both my panelists. I think nobody in this country would disagree that we as a country really need to clean this nation, and involving the people of the country is the best way to do anything. Regarding your question about Aam Aadmi Party launching a campaign of its own, Mr. Venkaiah and I had written a letter to Arvind Kejriwal asking for our help, And, you know, anything which is good for the country, Aam Aadmi Party does not believe in getting into politics, and we would want to lend a helping hand. So Arvind has asked all the volunteers to help in this campaign. You know, it's very liberating and empowering to see a Prime Minister of the country pick up a broom. But, right. You know, as of now, I think this is a rather simplistic solution to the whole issue of garbage, which is a big issue. And as, you know, I was in your previous program, I was talking about it. You know, just sweeping the garbage away from our backyard is a good first step. Okay. But then what happens to the garbage after that? Does it get dumped into the rivers? How do we, you know, I would have actually wanted the Prime Minister to talk about a long-term vision of the whole issue of sanitation and garbage disposal in this country.
Okay.
You know, and there is the corruption is also a big part of this garbage problem. You know, why
so you think the whole vision was not being presented?
Absolutely.
Today,
right, but now it looks like a band-aid solution to me.
Okay.
That yes, we clean our backyards and then what happens to that garbage, we don't really care. And you know, right. If you really, I was talking to some of the budgetary experts earlier in the day, and I was doing some analysis myself, if you look at the budget for Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, is the same as the Congress's budget for the Nirmal Bharat Abhiyan. So it's nothing new. You know, there's no new money, there's no new vision.
Absolutely.
It's just a repackaging
we,
of the
we
same
get your point.
Wine
we get your
bottle.
Point, Ms. Gupta. Do hold on to that thought. In fact, lots of reactions from the ground really coming in. Let me quickly go across to Kamaljeet Sandhu. She's sent us this walkabout with some of the children at the Valmiki Sadan. Let's hear out what they had to say.
Well, it's an exciting day here in Delhi, and not every day that you get an autograph from the Prime Minister, but these are the lucky children, and they're showing the autograph of the Prime Minister, and obviously a pen also. We'll talk to them. Now tell us, the Pradhan Mantri has talked to you about the conversation. क्या एक्साइटमेंट थी क्या बातचीत
बहुत एक्साइटमेंट थी हम मतलब इतने खुश थे हमें बिलीव नहीं होता कि वो सच में यहाँ पर आ रहे लेकिन जैसे सामने से आते हम सबके आंसू निकल रहे थे खुशी के हमारे बट जैसे सामने आए तो मतलब हमने जैसे अपना कैप आगे थे उन्होंने ऑटोग्राफ दिया फिर पूछा हमसे कि फ्यूचर में आप क्या बनना चाहते हो तो हम सब ने जैसे बोला कि हम सब डॉक्टर बनना चाहते हैं तो उन्होंने ये बोला कि बेस्ट ऑफ लक फॉर फ्यूचर अच्छे से बनना आपकी वजह से हमारा देश आगे जाएगा और बहुत सारी बातें उनसे
आप देश का फ्यूचर है सिटीजन है क्या सोचते हैं सफाई के बारे में आपको पहले नहीं सिखाया गया था क्या अलग सिखाया गया
नहीं हमें सिखाया तो जा रहा था पर इतना नहीं सिखाया जा रहा था कि क्या है अब स्कूल से बिल्कुल बताया जा रहा है कि हमें ये करना चाहिए हमें वो करना चाहिए हर चीज हमें बताई जा रही है सफाई के बारे में
फॉर श्योर Delhi city is a clean city, is a green city, but will this campaign sustain? Will they be able to take it on further? That really needs to be seen. With camera person Kishan Kumar, this is Kamaljeet Sandhu in Delhi for Headlines Today.
All right, let me cut across live to Atir Khan. He's standing by at Rajpath. Atir, we saw that massive gathering over there over which the Prime Minister presided upon. But tell us on the ground, how was the message received? We saw, Bollywood celebrities as well present at the event. So trying to send a message across to all sections of the society by a popular approach.
Well, that's right. It was a very positive, sort of show out here. There were eminent personalities, including film stars like Aamir Khan. Then we had sports persons like Vijender Singh. And there were many others. But then, this Prime Minister's imbibes confidence. You know, he's the one who's stating the obvious, which we all read in home science, perhaps, or maybe moral science. But then, when a Prime Minister makes such a statement, it attracts a lot of attention, and that's what happened. We saw all the people who gathered here when he was administering the oath, the pledge. Everybody was all eyes, and they were actually involved in the entire pledge. They folded their hands as the Prime Minister had asked them to, towards the sky, a tribute to Mahatma Gandhi. And then, as you see, this the entire mission plays at various levels, the cleanliness being the prime importance. But then it also sends out signals that there has to be good governance, and that starts with cleanliness. Remember, okay. He said in his earlier speech that FDI, first develop India, and then things will follow. Also, he's spoken about archaic laws. He's also spoken about weeding out corruption. So it is also symbolism which is playing at one level, but then he's as serious about cleanliness, because when he assumed office, the first thing he did was he cleaned up the Prime Minister's office. He made it, he ensured that every corridor, every room of the Prime Minister's office is clean.
Absolutely. Arthur, do stand by. Let's quickly play out some of the sound bites from that program earlier on. Here's Prime Minister Narendra Modi.
पूज्य बापू ने हमें संदेश दिया था, क्विट इंडिया क्लीन इंडिया, देशवासियों ने आजादी का आंदोलन चला करके देश को पूज्य बापू के नेतृत्व में गुलामी से मुक्त कराया। लेकिन पूज्य बापू का, क्लीन इंडिया का सपना अभी अधूरा है। जब इस लोगों को देखा, एकदम से मुझे बड़ा सटीक लगा। मैं देख रहा हूं इन चश्मों से महात्मा गांधी देख रहे हैं कि बेटे भारत को स्वच्छ किया कि नहीं किया। ये लोगो सिर्फ लोगो नहीं है, इन चश्मा से गांधी देख रहे हैं क्या किया, क्या कर रहे हो, कैसे कर रहे हो, कब तक करोगे। और इसलिए जब ये गांधी के चश्मों का लोगो हम देखते हैं, जो चश्मे खुद हमें कहते हैं, स्वच्छ भारत का संदेश देते हैं, भारत के कर सकता है, भारतवासी कर सकते हैं। अगर भारतवासी कम से कम खर्च में मार्स में पहुंच सकते हैं, तो क्या भारतवासी अपना गली मोहल्ला साफ नहीं कर सकते हैं? मार्स को पहुंचाने के लिए कोई प्रधानमंत्री नहीं गया था, कोई मंत्री नहीं गया था, हमारे वैज्ञानिकों ने किया था, भारत माता के संतानों ने किया था। सफाई भी हम सब मिलकर के करनी है।
All right, all this, all these messages by Prime Minister Narendra Modi, let's try and read into them as well a little bit. Dilip Chirayan, you know, we heard Prime Minister Narendra Modi, he's sending out these messages, all right. But can politics be really kept aside when you see this mission, when you see this kind of an address, and what are your thoughts on that?
In a sense, this is a very non-threatening kind of campaign to launch. It's value loaded in favor of anybody who starts it. But the danger that Mr. Modi is courting at the moment is that he's also opened it up onto social media with his challenge to people to clean up. And social media has a relentless scrutiny on what goes on. So I think that it's important for him to make sure that key stakeholders in it, which is the citizens of this country, continue to show interest in it. I take Reena's point completely that he needs to think of the big ticket items on the top in terms
but
of technology.
Isn't that also in terms of positive sign opening up to the social media? So there will be constant criticism and close eye on how this you know, mission is progressing.
This can't succeed without close scrutiny, because as Reena and I think Javed were mentioning, there is the corruption issue also. You know, it's not about funds. I think funds exist. It doesn't matter who had more funds or less funds. That's political. As long as the funds are sufficient, and as long as the other thing that Prime Minister has to figure out is that this has to feed back into his Make in India thing. You know, you can't be producing things which are toxic at the end of the day. So, you know, you've got to make sure that water bottles can be quickly, you know, dealt with, or the material in which it's made. We, you know, what are the two things that every citizen of this country sees most often? It's the wrappers of processed foods which litter all our cities, and plastic bottles, besides all the other toxic litter of hospitals, which Reena mentioned earlier. Now, these things need a technological fix at the production stage, not at the post-consumption stage.
So getting in green technology is also needed at
the manufacturing stage. So you make products which don't have a problem of disposal.
Right. I'm going to get Javed Ansari and Reena also on this in just a bit.